You get to work your butt off. If you think that you're gonna go and accomplish something really special and be the best in anything in the world, and you think you can do it without working, you make a big mistake. Because no matter what I did, if it was in bodybuilding or in acting or if it is in the political arena, it always took a lot of work. And you got to put out and you got to, you know, sometimes make a lot of sacrifices, notice. If you're not willing to work hard, forget about it.
Everyone has a problem with time, but the day is 24 hours and we sleep six. Now I know there's some out there that say, whoa, I need eight. Well, I say just sleep a little faster, because the bottom line is we have 6 hours of sleep, 24 hours are available. So you have 18 hours now available to your work, your family, your hobbies, and also to learn something new or to do something new, which could easily be that you want to learn a new language or that you want to read as a New Year's resolution, I have to read a book every week, or you say, I'm gonna go and reshape my body. So you're gonna go and take this hour out of your schedule and say, I'm gonna train an hour every day. So this is, for most people, a huge challenge, but it is totally doable, I can tell them, because the kind of things that I did when I came to this country, I mean, I went to school, I was working in construction, I was working out my 5 hours a day, I was taking acting classes from 8 o'clock at night to 12 midnight. I was doing all of those things. I wanted to make sure that out of the 24 hours of the day, that I don't waste one single hour. Those hours were too precious. And so then I just want to tell people, don't give me this thing, I have a difficult time with the time and I don't have time for this and I don't have that. You have time, you make the time. The most important thing is that you have a vision, that you have a goal. Because without that vision and without that goal, again, you're drifting around and you're never gonna end up anywhere. People don't become successful just by accident. You know, I mean, maybe the guy that found gold in California and started the gold rush, but don't count on that. That's the one in a lifetime kind of a situation. So you got to really have a specific goal. And to me, to have that vision that I want to be Mr. Universe, that I want to be the greatest bodybuilder of all time, that was a great vision, and that specifically to look like Reg Park and to be up there on that stage and to lift the trophy overhead and to win the championship over and over and over again. So that was a great goal. You have to have a goal. Now, it doesn't have to be that specific goal, but it has to have some goal. This is why I always recommend to people, sit down, take your time, and start thinking about, why do you want to work out? What is your goal? That can be as crazy as it is. It could be that, you know, I want to impress girls. If that's your goal, so be it, but it motivates you. It could be that you're emulating a certain, bodybuilder or a certain football player, a certain boxer, whatever it is. Have those pictures put all over the wall like I did when I was a kid. I put pictures of Reg Park and of Sonny Liston, of boxers and of Ali and of powerlifters and weightlifters all over my bedroom, wall. So that every day when I go to sleep, every day when I wake up, I look at those pictures and they motivate me. You need that motivation, and then therefore you have this kind of imprint in front of you all the time and you know exactly what you're chasing. This is why I always smiled when I was in the gym. People always came up to me and says, why are you smiling? You're working out 5 hours a day. You're doing the same as the other guys, but the other guys have a sour face. They're pissed off that they have to do another rep or another set or something. I looked forward to another 1,000 reps of sit-ups. I looked forward to another 500 pounds of leg press or squat. I looked forward to doing more and more curls. Why? Because I knew that every rep that I did and every set that I did and more weights that I lifted, I get one step closer to turning that vision into reality. So I was turned on by that. I was excited. I couldn't wait to get to the gym.